Thank you. you did that in a good day. They're upbeat. The other day, we were challenged by our weather. People, our employees, parties were out in the streets, even police come. Everybody's helping us, participating. Last night, I was going around the city at 1 a.m. Visited some institutions. They were all wide awake. And there's mobile police mobile.
Like security state.
Yes. So we have the social integration program for senior citizens, the students allowance, tax plan, and hopefully in the coming months, by January, we're going to build a new slaughterhouse for free.
Where in Manila?
In Tundo.
Okay, Tundo.
We arranged some modification of an old contract from the previous administration. We're really going to do vertical development in the next 10 years, but we want to address the basic every day and to address long term also the social administration. The way I know it as food boy from Tundo, the way I know how it feels for our needs. This is experience.
The issue of Clinic Manila Bay is federal government or is local government?
It's supposed to be local government, but there was a decision of the Supreme Court mandating or directing all national government and local government to clean up Manila Bay. But in the past, recent history, the local government did not disagree. So DPWH and MBA and DNR all together is cleaning up Manila Bay. And we're very happy. And I told the Secretary Simango, the least thing that you can expect from us is we welcome you in the city of Manila. Continue cleaning the bay because they have the funds, they have the equipment and manpower. Hopefully, come 2 months from now, there will be a new beach, 50 meter beach, perpendicular to the shore. And the STP of Sonic Street plant is now being built. Air quantifier that machine identify the pollution in the air and the water pollution to be installed. I allow them to install in one of the buildings by the hospital.
How much security is the problem in Manila and how much is it in Europe?
We have about 2,000 based on the recent data given to me. Last week, we have 2,000 peddlers, drugs, which is still existing. We only clear 89 barangays of drugs that week out of 896. 10%. But when I assume offices fly one, 30 barangays were cleared immediately of drugs. In the past, they only cleared an average of 17 a year. So it seems things are moving towards a better direction. And today, after we meet by 10 o'clock, because I give a direct particular area, I give them 1 week. And I think today is the result of that directive from last week. We apprehended Allah under the list. Well, that's another challenge. But we will continue to make their life like a living hell in the city of Manila. No way. Literally, no way. No matter who they are, even elected officials. send a specific order. While we also protect human rights, we always tell them to follow certain rules. We protect the rights of the suspect. At the same time, you protect also your rights because you're part of the law enforcement. So if there's a chance of putting high level of tolerance in incident, that will be a better scenario. But in a given time, they can do it, protect their security also, their life. They're entitled, our reporters are entitled, while the suspect is entitled to be protected, the same thing with our reporters. But it's very difficult to hear.
So you're an inspiration for all of us, I think. I'm so happy to hear about the New York here in Oi.
I'm just happy.
I remember you're too young for this. In the 1980s, New York was full of garbage.
Yeah.
And you came Giuliani and cleaned it.
The window, the broken window.
I could say you drive with a car, you guys were coming to clean your window. If you didn't take the money, you were in trouble. So we watched an armed robbery, me and my wife, in the middle of the 1980s. Let me tell you a bit about this kind of the Philippines, and then we speak about what we did and what we did. We never met. First, we have a relationship system. It's based on four historic decisions. Two from the Israeli side. First, the population wave on counter-terrorism. President mentioned Israel assistance in Marawi. But maybe today, terrorism is not a Philippine government. It's not a vigilance, it's a global government. Those that committed the suicide attack in first and the second, they came from something from Indonesia. So we go very good. Second is when we did the guy from Uganda. We are far away, it's not our neighborhood. We did our biggest ever in the population in the history, was done in Leyte. So this is from our side, from your side. Because all of us remember President Manuel Quezon.
But you know, Philippines is very hospitable in Manuel. At the time when nobody wanted to open the door to only a Filipino leader.
And I want his birthday is in 2 weeks, I will be the keynote speaker at his birthday event. And then President Manuel Rojas, another thing, when the UN has proposed in 1947, yes or no, for a Jewish state, if it was no, I wasn't here. It was the only Asian country to vote yes. That's why you don't have visas to Israel. And with this, we beat our population. We have a long historic population on all the issues, agriculture, education. We have Filipinos in Israel. We're not quite away from many from Manila. They dwell in Israel. We are not allowed to have guys. Not legal. Me or none of us can. We have only elderly people in need, people with disabilities, with a special long process, can have assistance. And we have 30,000 Filipinos. We treat them well. They get paid well. They have balut and alu in Tel Aviv. They get the churches, you know, we love them. And I want to thank you, by the way, for them. We are going to open very soon Israel for the first time for Filipinos who work at the tourism industry. Now, I take your story because you fight corruption. Many years, the Filipinos that went to Israel paid amount between $9,000 to $20,000 just to go to Israel's placement fees. Here, maybe here, little in Israel. And we tried for President's administration to have a government to govern the
language
until we built it. He went to Israel. We took him last September to Israel. And then we signed the agreement. He and Netanyahu. There are some places in Israel, not that far, but it will be $800. And we start implementing by the end of the year. This is exactly how we bring money back to it. Why the Filipino that lives in Israel and has the family in Toto needs to pay $10,000 to govern Israel? We didn't accept it. Only put that, you know, media noise will only put in this administration. Now, we have a long cooperation with so many institutions in Manila. I want to start with my wife because she has a project in Tondo. Maybe you can describe it, then we speak about education and development assistance.
Yeah, about less than a year ago, I visited a school, kindergarten in Tondo, right in the middle of the neighborhood. Which looks like an oasis in the neighborhood. It's run by an Italian pastor.
Escuela.
Yeah.
Escuela de
School of Joy.
And the leader of the Jewish community, Leo Lichtenstein, is the one that puts the money.
Yes.
75 children, correct?
75 children visit the school every day. We give clothing, food twice a day, and education, school education. I mean, they have, you know, two large rooms, air conditioned, clean, with plants around it, really, really, really nice. And once they graduate with kindergarten and go to public school, you can see the difference. What basic education and basic nutrition can do for a small child. They are first in class when they go to public school. It's amazing. So now I have a project now. I'm collecting toys and books in English and Tagalog to build a library for them.
Thank you.
So no problem. It's my pleasure. It's my passion now.
We got some ambassadors, we found the Australian ambassador, the Vietnamese. I came there, the key, I think, of the key, you know, Mano? They came to me and they asked me to give them the Mano, the blessing. Yeah, the blessing. Amazing kids.
Actually, Yulia, yeah, she donated her kids' toys already and books. I have so many.
Thank you.
So it's an ongoing project. We're going to build a library so the parents can come and borrow toys and books and also the, you know, things that they could have in the establishment. Kindergarten itself,
and then
to have, I think it's very
good. Yeah. We are not a checking, but we are not a checking. It's right, usually we give the know-how, the expertise, you know, whatever. Right. So this is about it. Maybe you want to speak about what I'm doing.
Yeah, recently we had a cooperation with
Universidad de Lima. Here?
Yes.
Especially the parola, say, to Parangay 101, Parangay 101, 128, 129, 123. These are Bayside Parangay.
Bayside Parangay,
that are exposed to. It's a challenge in humanity.
Now, we have the development assistance program. We have a lot of activities on agriculture and water, but this is less relevant, I think, for Manila. But I think the areas that might be relevant for you is education. We're talking about kids with disabled children or higher education and we do short-term courses in Israel. 2 weeks we send people and they training, or we can bring in 2020, we can bring 2 experts that we train the trainers. Okay?
I would love to send our students there.
Okay, sir. Okay.
So we can sponsor the airfare.
Yeah, I know. And this is so what we need in order to complete a good contact person in your office that will be a contact for us for the issue of development assistance. Who can be
the of
excellent. So this is one in the program. She's a Filipino. She speaks very good Tagalog.
Oh, padala ko yung ating mga PLM students at UDM students.
Yeah, we actually approached them. Yes, we had the history, can I tell you? Manila and Haifa has a sister city relationship. And as a certain, yes, may exchange program tayo dati, but this is way before. And this is what.
And I'm willing to spend.
Yes, sir.
Spend the tickets. Because that's a challenge most of the time.
Awesome.
When we send students abroad, the city will not help them.
Actually, sir, yes. This is why we had a problem with that, because the Israeli kids can come and visit, but the students in Manila, you're
not. Yeah, challenge.
Yes,
that's why, in my own little way, when I was a vice president, every time that the students of PLM or any students of public schools will go and compete, learn, you know, something from other parts of the world, I try to help them, because I think that's a good exposure for them.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So this is the first thing that I want to do, and I want to adopt a student. My thing is to come as an ambassador to take office. And I like to talk with the kids. I like to tell them what is to be, you know, to give them the feeling they meet a VIP, even though I'm not sitting there, but to feel that they are, and then to invite them to them and say, I want to do something like this. And we need a recommendation from you to think together which school we can do, we can do some resources.
You want elementary or high school?
You will tell me what is
okay.
That.
Rosauro Almario Elementary School.
You will tell me what is it. I like to touch, this is a custom, this is not what I like. Usually I like to be with a jeans edition.
Okay. I wear this because you're coming.
Usually I wear the
top. Then there are two more things. First, we mentioned another case of, and every year we have and the other one is the Israeli Holocaust Day, and we choose every year to do it in universities in Manila, not the Jewish community, but we did it this year at the Emilio Aguinaldo College and at
Liceo.
And next year we will do it at Filipino Women's University, and maybe you can recommend us which other university to educate children. The story is not to tell the Filipinos that the role model, where that case on and how it's important, because the education system, they don't teach about this great thing that, you know, they don't. I find myself as Israeli ambassador, don't go around and teach it.
But during our younger years, although I'm still young, we are always told and taught almost every day of what our heroes do. And in fact, there is also a pamphlet. We call it the Students' Digest, being printed by the national government, the Ministry of Education at the time, that we read about current events. Yeah. In Abu is all same generation. So we are known to functions of government. That's why we know where to ask help if we need help. This is the executive branch, this is the legislative branch, this is what they can do, this is what they can do. I don't know if this teaching that kind of...
So we do as much as we can, because I think we should learn from this paper. And Quezon is a place, we have very close relationship with the family, and I ask them, the Jews were always received with open arms in the beginning.
I always believe in history. In history, we talk of things you should not do and you should do. It will teach you naturally because you know already the result of your future action.
Not many people learn from history.
If you don't know how to read it and understand it, you're a foolish person.
You're right. And then I understood that you never been to the Holy Land.
Not yet.
Now I know, you know what your president told me last September? The president told me to tell the injuries. My late parents to visit the Holy Land, they didn't fulfill it. I should purpose, I fulfill it. I want to fulfill, I don't know if it's a dream, but they say it's their bucket list. We would like you very much to travel to Israel next year.
Okay, sure.
Now, I tell you what's the format. First, we have elections in Israel in September. So
how is Mr. Netanyahu? I've been hearing Netanyahu since I was in elementary.
Yeah. I'll tell you what is the vision. I tell you what's the vision. You know, it's interesting because that's a vision. In 96, he was elected for the first time for 3 years. Yeah. Then he went down for 10 years and became there. Our GDP per capita in 96, I was in government, was $14,000. And remember, he set the goal to reach $17,000 GDP per capita. 1996, we are now 2019, 40,000 GDP per capita in Israel. This is the vision.
Speaking about water,
you know, our late president, Shimon Peres, you know, we have every year El Nino.
Shimon
Peres. We have every year El Nino in Israel. Every year. We had 5 consecutive years, El Nino, no water. Only last year we were blessed. And he said, well, what's this? To create new sources of water. So all the home water consumption in Israel come from desalination. From desalination. Then all the sewage water are recycled with irrigation, 85%. The Philippines, your challenge is not lack of water, it's water management and water safety. So vision, you have a vision. And you implement it from the beginning. We have a formal, Sara Duterte was there, but you participated as a mayor of the Apostle. We have an annual mayor's conference in Israel, in Jerusalem. Usually it's around March or April, because of the elections, still wait. But they get mayors, 20-30 from all over the world to discuss urban issues. Assuming this will take place in the local elections, I would like you already, in principle, to tell me, Ambassador, I will come.
Yes, I will come.
Okay. If this doesn't work, there's no, then we find another chance just to come by yourself. So we'll come back to you. We don't have the dates because we have elections probably towards the end of the year. Many of the big mayors, they've been there. And I think you are one of the few that have ever been to the mayor. You're busy with other things. So and it will enable you to visit the holy places also, you know, because this is also there, but also to see the technology and other things. So this is something I put in my bucket list for next year. Anything else that you think we can, I am not formal, you saw me already, you know. I think when I saw you, the first time I told you, you have to fix the promenade of Rojas Boulevard. Because, touristically, there is a potential. We do a lot of things touristically. You know, Philippines has not a visa, is very well. But Manila is a potential to bring tourism, and tourism into this money. Today, they come to do shopping all of Asia, and I would put it also as a challenge.
Yeah, I was given opportunity to talk to the largest conglomerate in the country in less than 1 month, almost 5 or 6 of 10
big ones
in the Forbes list.
Okay.
To talk to them personally. So I discussed certain policies, I pinpointed certain areas like Escolta and everything, and all other things. You know, what I asked them in return for them to go back to Manila, just very simple. 70% of your employees should be Manilans. And they agreed.
Thank you.
I did not ask for anything. I'll give you ease, I'll give you certain holidays, tax plan, and so on. You go back here and develop, redevelop, invest in Manila, you will have all these freebies. The only thing that I will ask is, every time that you put up a new branch, new corporation, new company, new building, and so on and so forth, 70% must be Manila.
And there's no lack of manpower.
We've been producing graduates. We are the number one producer of graduates. All the schools except for Ateneo, we used to be in Manila. If you name it, they are located in Manila. In the southeast, southwest area, and the center area, or we call it the Minjola.
We have in our legislation, we don't have a constitution, a legislation which prioritizes the capital in funds, specific areas and to give incentives for the capital. I don't know if you have it in Manila, but it's something that I would look into it.
Yeah, that's why I initiated the deal. Asking them directly what we wanted for the people of Manila. Directly. Yeah. Now, don't wait for the law to be passed, because that is the direction. So that you will know that later on there will be a new law the city that requires you, but I don't want to keep on requiring people. We can talk informally, and that will be true to our words. modesty aside, the president said the ease of doing business must be implemented. In 3 days' time, there must be business permit, for example, in Manila, one day.
Faster than in my country.
Yes, one day, modesty aside. From 11 steps, 8 windows became 1 window with 3 steps. From 5 to 10 days of waiting, one day you will have a new business. We've been doing it for almost more than 10 days now. So far, the batting average is very good. As long as your paper is complete, you cannot. There's a guy who said in Facebook, for the first time in history, he said, 45 minutes, I got my business plan. Yes. I did not say that, he said that. That's his experience. And because of that, one corporation, like SM, offered their free space. Can you imagine their business is renting spaces or leasing spaces? We got 1,000 square meters of free space. So that we can have our extension office for the incoming bulk renewal of business permit. By January, we'll be receiving here in this area about 54,000 people will renew their business permit. So that's 54,000 foot traffic, good for them and better for the citizens of Manila.
The
people are appreciating it, and they keep on asking me, you rest, naman, as they said, no? You take care, blah, blah, blah. I'm happy, I appreciate those concerns of our people. But with all honesty, I have no reason to rest, because we were deprived of opportunity for quite some time. You know, there is no taqib 20 years ago.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, no, there is taqib,
yeah.
But there is no BGC.
Yeah, I know.
There is no such thing as MRT3, MRT2, Trinoma in Quezon City, UP Technohub, UP Town. Now there's Capitol Commons in Pasig. No, there's always Manila. It's always Manila. There's such a thing as Entertainment City in Pasig and Paranaque. All of this development is just in the surroundings of Manila. And if we come back, if we come and ask us, oh, what happened to you in 18 years? Oh, we're still Manila. That's the only thing that I can say. That's why I cannot afford to rest. Because you can always lose money and earn back money. But if you lose time, you cannot buy back time. And time is opportunity. And I believe, I don't know with economists, the most expensive commodity in this world, if it is called and categorized as commodity, is time. If we lose that, we lose opportunity. So every day. There must be something going. We have to push to the maximum. Everybody, I'll push myself to the maximum so that everybody will follow suit.
So whatever you can do in the first year, it will have an impact on this. But you give all of us, I must tell you, inspiration and hope.
Thank you.
I must tell you, the Filipinos have high expectations for you. I watch it from this as a point, but the expectations are high. Sharing our experience. We are not
thank you.
This is our approach, you know. And whatever we can do, the doors are open. We work very closely on those things. I hope that you can come with the whole event next year. And
yes, please.
And you don't have to put some souvenirs.
Let's go to the restaurant.
It's not this photo, but just okay. This
not Mr. Lazarus.
We wear this photo.
Yeah. But this is Eduardo.
I know. That's why I see, because he's one. He's an accused
like a total one.
He's one of the greatest friends of Israel. He's been in Israel, right? You're making something he's not a Christian.
No, I'm not.
Okay. And this is in his office or him?
Yeah, in his office.
You went to the Quezon City.
And it's a gift to me.
Right. So I mean, this thing was your last birthday, and you are very, and they just celebrated the anniversary of it. I saw about them, and I'm very happy to see
The first gift from him was my 31 years, my mm-hmm. said.
About 70 years, more or less, relationship because Filipinos at that time until now very hospitable. One of our greatest virtue, or if we can put it as kind-hearted individual in this world, to welcome Jewish people at the time wherein there's a big challenge in that part of the world. Through Manuel Tesson, now we have ties, and thank you very much also in advance invitation to be in the Holy Land. As a Catholic, of course, everybody's dream being a Catholic. But again, Your Excellency, thank you for helping people of Manila. We know that you're helping communities in the city, and thank you in advance your intention to continue to help the people of Manila. Again, welcome to the capital city of the Philippines, the city of Manila.
Presentation.